The Bridgestone World Solar Challenge is a grueling 3,000-kilometer test of endurance from Darwin to Adelaide, taking in 9 compulsory control stops through some of the most inhospitable landscapes on Earth. 2 years ago, Western Sydney University entered the World Solar Challenge for the first time. The entrepreneurial drive and the expertise we gained through the development and lab testing enabled us to make it to Adelaide. Learning from our experiences in that race, this time we were determined to come back even stronger. Nothing was off the table. We wanted to build a car using cutting-edge technology that would demonstrate the incredible potential of electric vehicles. Using our state-of-the-art lab and LSM, the crew designed and built custom carbon fiber components to make this car lighter and faster. We tested it over 1,000 kilometers on the track and in the outback, working day and night to make sure we were ready to compete with the world's best. We pushed the boundaries of innovation and design.
Happy with that now?
To be given the green light to compete with the most efficient road vehicles on the planet.
And I have to say that this is the most stressful sticker I've ever gotten in my life.
The solar car project is about learning in a real-world context. It brings the theoretical concepts through into a practical environment, helping students to apply their knowledge and expand their real-world industry experience.
Some of the world's most efficient electric road vehicles. One day, I'm sure we will all be driving electric cars. And today, that dream becomes a reality. And for those who have traveled around the world to be here, it is truly a great adventure of dreams.
I wasn't nervous, to be honest with you. I just wanted to get going. We knew what it was capable of, but I just wanted to see it in action in the race. I wanted to see the power coming in. I like seeing the amount of power we're harvesting. I like looking at the numbers, you know.
Next up is another Australian entry, the Western Sydney University team, who've done remarkably well. This is their second entry in the World Solar Challenge. Well done to the team. You've done a tremendous job. We wish you well on your journey. And you're about to be flagged off, and we look forward to seeing you in Adelaide.
We had made it to Darwin through quarantine, customs, and safety inspections. Now the real challenge began. Over 4 demanding days driving across the Australian outback, our crew had the adventure of a lifetime. But it wasn't easy. We learned through teamwork.
3, 2, 1. In the mornings and afternoons, we have to capture as much sunlight as we can. So we start the race at 8 a.m. and we finish at 5 p.m. wherever we are. What that means is that we have a couple hours in the morning and a couple hours in the afternoon to charge this car.
When we stop at a control stop, we're spraying water over the array to cool it, as well as to clean the array of any dirt or dust that we've picked up on the way. When we cool the array, we increase our power output by a few hundred watts. A few hundred watts is, you know, 10 kilometres an hour extra speed. So it's a lot of energy that we're wasting if we're not cooling the array.
I'm very joyous because our solar car team have proven that our students can take the idea from the design level into building level into performance.
You know what we'll do?
We have people from a variety of disciplines. We have mechanical engineering, we have computer engineering, we have electrical engineering, we have design, we have business, media, and so on. This project allowed students to have a direct contact with industry, and this always was led by students.
We had to overcome the punishing temperatures on the road, physical and mental exhaustion, and constantly evaluating technical challenges.
Well done, fellas.
But we made it, proving that we could handle any situation. And together, we managed to push the boundaries of precision engineering, making it to the Adelaide finishing line in the top 10.
You got divided road all the way to the city. Good luck, fellas.
Thanks, guys. We'll see you in Adelaide.
One thing that the Solar Car Challenge exemplifies so well is that our students have that capacity to overcome difficulties and challenges, that they're able to resolve problems working together in a team. And our team did so well and was so competitive right throughout the race. Just goes to show with a bit of ingenuity and Western Sydney cunning, we can be as good as anyone in the world.
Welcome to Adelaide, guys.
When we actually got into the city and we pulled up at the marshalling point, it kind of really sunk in what's happened, and I said, yeah, we made it. Unbelievable.
Shit, man, we did it!
I'm really relieved now. A lot of hard work for this.
Daniel!